A very good morning to all of you. Welcome back to Seven Science. We were studying about the chapter The Living World, Adaptation and Classification. In this class, I'm going to explain you adaptation in the animals with respect to nutrition and how animals are classified. Now, we will see how adaptation takes place for ingestion of food in animals. Based on the mode of nutrition. Nutrition is the intake of nutrients. Based on the mode of nutrition, animals are generally classified as herbivores and carnivores. As I've told in the last class, herbivores are those animals which depend upon the plants, whereas carnivores are those animals which depend upon another animals for food. Special adaptations are seen to make the process of feeding easy. Changes that take place in the various organs and life process of organism that enable them to live, feed, reproduce, protect, and perpetuate themselves depending upon the habitat and its geographical condition are called adaptations. Adaptation is a slow and it is not a sudden process. It is a gradual and continuous process. Further, what we see now is Darwin's theory of evolution. Charles Darwin, a biologist, studied numerous types of plants and animals. Those organisms will only survive which adapt themselves to the changing environment. This is called the theory of survival of the fittest. This was Darwin's first principle. A simple example of the theory of survival of the fittest. If we have a small space in which only 50 seeds are to be sown, but if we sow 100 seeds, in that small space, though not all 100, but few seeds will come up as a plant. Only those plants who could fight back for the space, water, oxygen, only those plants will grow in that excess capacity. This is what Charles Darwin tried to prove. The one who is the fittest will only survive. The second principle of Darwin's theory. If an organism is born with a new beneficial characteristic and is able to survive this change, is preserved in the next generation. This theory is also called as natural selection theory. What this actually means, Darwin's second principle. It is also known as Darwin's second principle, but what it actually means. In the olden times, DDT was used to kill mosquitoes. But later on, the mosquito population developed a beneficial characteristic to fight back the DDT. And it was preserved in the next generation, forwarded to the next generation. And this is how the DDT did not kill the entire mosquito population, because these mosquito population developed a beneficial characteristic to survive this harmful change of DDT, and it was forwarded to the next generation. Binomial nomenclature by Carl Linnaeus. binomial nomenclature is used to identify each organism. Accordingly, a scientific name has been assigned to each organism. The reason is to maintain uniformity all over the world. It consists of two parts. The first part is genus and the second part is species. All identified organisms have been assigned a binomial name as per the guidelines of the International Code of Nomenclature. All the organisms of a species are so similar that irrespective of differences in color, height, habitats and habits, they can reproduce among themselves and form new individuals like themselves. For example, all domestic cats in the world belong to the same species. The same is true in case of animals like hen, cow, dog, etc. and plants like mango, wheat, maize, etc. According to Carl Linnaeus, he grouped the animals, he classified them. Following are some examples of organism from the kingdom. He called the entire living things as a kingdom and then classified the kingdom into plants and animals. Since we are studying specifically nomenclature, instead of calling living organisms, grouping them into plants and animals, he grouped them, gave them the scientific name. So entire living kingdom was classified into plantae and animalia. Here is a list of the living things with their scientific name based on the method of binomial nomenclature. The word nomenclature indicates giving them a scientific name which is uniform all over the world. Living thing like dog, scientific name Canis lupus familiaris. The word canis because dogs are specialized with canine teeth. Cow, Bos taurus, hibiscus, scientific name Hibiscus rosa sinensis, jowar, sorghum bicolor. All these are the living things with the common name and their scientific name. I hope all the concepts are now clear, the adaptations in both plants and animals, and how common living things are given their scientific name, and the process is called as binomial nomenclature. As a science assignment, I want you people to write list of 10 living organisms which is not included in the PPT along with their scientific names. Stay at home, be safe. Thank you.